I wonder how many people consider themselves to be creative people. I know I consider myself creative. At least, sometimes. I work as a graphic designer, and like most of us, I started making art when I was a kid. I kind of stumbled into graphic design in high school when I was accidentally placed into an Adobe design course. And honestly, I was pissed when that happened. The course was on level, and I was used to taking honors and advanced placement classes. I remember thinking, this class is gonna tank my GPA. But I ended up falling in love with design because it gave me an outlet in ways that STEM classes couldn't. I got to use my perfectionism in order to meet the specific requirements of each project, and I still was able to add my own artistic touch. Graphic design and digital art require a lot of creativity, but as the youngest person at an advertising agency and the lowest designer on the totem pole, I don't always get to exercise the right side of my brain, so to speak. A lot of the work I get are third and fourth phase projects, in which I'm either perfectly recreating something that already exists within a brand's assets, or I'm adapting it for a different platform. My most exciting projects are the ones in which I get to add my own personal interpretation to the artwork. But often, these are also the most anxiety-inducing projects, because there's a lot of pressure on me to make something new, something fresh, something never before seen, but also something that's exactly what the client wants to see. I know good design when I see it, but I struggle to meet my own high standards when it comes to actually designing. So I thought to myself, if I struggle so much with creativity in a traditionally creative field, how do those around me define, perceive, and incorporate creativity into their lives? How do they handle it? I asked some friends of mine to give me their thoughts on creativity.
I think of creativity as using your imagination to communicate something to someone through different mediums. So within science fields, you're constantly trying to build off of something that someone's already done. So you're going to have to be creative in order to find new ways to test something, to discover new things. And you have to be creative to do that. Otherwise, you're just repeating what someone has already done. So zoology is primarily working with animals, whether that's research or with zookeeping. In something such as zookeeping, if they're in a confined state, usually you have to do something in order to enrich their lives. And so creating something that stimulates them and also simulates their own natural environment takes creativity and is something that you kind of need to do every day, because otherwise they just get bored of the same thing.
I definitely think that sciences can be creative, and specifically within engineering, creativity is vital part of the profession, because we can't just keep creating the same things. You need to keep creating new solutions and innovating and coming up with original ideas that can keep improving the state of being for humans, wildlife, medicine, whatever it is. Like within engineering, I think creativity is probably the most vital skill. I think that I incorporate creativity into my field and my studies just by whenever I'm faced with a problem, trying to come up with new ways to solve it so that I'm not just doing the same thing over and over again. You know, looking for different resources, looking for ways to implement previous knowledge I already have in a way that I wouldn't have before. And not just listening to what professors tell me, actually thinking about the concepts and thinking deeper into whatever I'm learning about.
Hearing their perspectives made me realize that creativity doesn't have to be stressful. Even though a lot of my job revolves around a creative process, I don't need to psych myself out. The most important part about being creative is being open to discovering new ways to solve an old puzzle. A lot of times, I can find myself within standard design theories and methods, but if I want to enhance my creative side, I need to break out of my self-imposed bubble. I want to challenge myself to take more creative risks in hopes of gaining more artistic reward.